Okay, here, we're gonna talk today about how to dial in a vise, machine vise. Most common work holding device that you're gonna use inside of a milling machine is a machine vise. But when you put it on here, you can't be guaranteed that it's straight. We need this back edge called the solid jaw to run perfectly parallel to the X axis. Only way to be sure we have that is not just looking at it with our eye, we have to dial it in. So we're gonna use a dial indicator today. Each line on here, and that's okay if you can't see them when you look at one, reads usually 1/2 of a thousandth. So 0.0005 thousandths, 5/10 thousandths. Each big line's 1,000th. So I'm gonna put this into the spindle and use it against the back edge of the vise to dial it in. So I'm gonna be in hand jog, and then I'm gonna turn the spindle so I can actually get the drive dogs that fit in here facing me, so I get it in the right. Push the button, turn it. Now, as you can see, that thing still moves. I can't trust that to be right. So I need to lock that spindle so it won't move. So I'm gonna do a little program called, gonna go into MDI, manual data input, MDI. And I'm gonna put in M19, right enter. That is gonna orientate and lock the spindle. So we're gonna close the doors for a second, so it'll run. Now you didn't see it move, but now, see, now that's locked. That's not gonna move, that's locked. Oh yeah, I can move it like that with my hand, but it's not gonna move much. So now we're gonna go back into hand jog, into Z, and I'm gonna start bringing down the head. Now, I'm gonna stop real quick here. Don't just mindlessly bring it down. This is positioned right now behind here. You can't see it from your angle, but if I keep coming down, I'm gonna smash this right in the top of the vise. So Y, we're gonna bring it forward in Y. Now, you say forward, the table's moving that way, but you're always the spindle when you're in a machine. You're always the spindle. So by moving the table that way in the head of, in the mind of the machine, it's actually moving the cutter. So I'm moving this, but it's actually, it's like when you're sitting next to a car in a parking lot and they back out and you think you're rolling forward, you get that weird sensation. You're not moving, but you feel like you are. Well, this isn't moving, but the machine thinks it is. So I move that, now I'm gonna bring it in Z. And this is, if you're not sure if you're in the right spot, this is a very simple project. Stick your head in there and look. So now we're gonna come down. I'm gonna get down here so I can see I'm just below the top of the vise. We gotta be careful we don't get too low because we got screw holes in here. And if I go across them, it's gonna jimmy jack that thing around. So now I'm gonna go on Y. I'm gonna move it back. If you notice right now, I'm on zero on my indicator. So I'm gonna walk that back. Don't get crazy. I always safe cracker it, put my hand down there and slowly bring it back. Oh, that's too far. By 1,000ths now. Click, 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 click. Okay. So I'm on 10. I'm gonna turn the dial for zero. It's not that important, but I like to have it on zero. I'm on zero right there. I'm gonna move in hand jog so that I can make sure this is right. I'm gonna step over here out of the way so you can see the indicator as I do it. Go to 10,000ths, click. Whoa, see how that's moving? So what that did, it moved off. We're gonna go the other way now. Starts picking it up right about there. Oh, and that's getting heavier. As it's going like this, if I push on the front of this, I can see that move in a clockwise fashion. So I know that it gets heavier as it moves clockwise. That means that my vise is literally sitting with this end closer than that end. Because as I come across it, it gets heavier here. So I need to move that back so it's a straight. So I'm gonna move over here a little farther. Now I'm gonna use my highly precision instrument to move it back. So I'm gonna tap on this side. Since it's sitting like this, if I tap on this side here, I will move it back. So we're just gonna kind of tap on it, get it back over to zero. I'm gonna come back over here. We're gonna just walk it back the other way now. Well, it's still still walking away. So I'm gonna move it in Y, get myself more what we call push away on there. Oh, come on, Y. There we go. Ooh, yeah. Don't break your indicator. Okay. X, we're gonna move over this way. Still way too much. We're gonna come back over. Gonna hit this. I think I got a long way to go, so I'm gonna give myself some room. Move it back. Still walking off on me. Sometimes what I'll do is go part way, tap it. No, getting closer now. A little bit, take it back to zero. Tap, now go. Getting closer. Something I didn't mention was when you're doing this, I loosened up one side on my bolts here. I loosened up one of my hold downs. This one's not snug, but it's a little loose. But if you loosen up both of them, then you get this cattywampus thing going on and you don't know what you're doing. By tying this one down with some pressure, I have a pivot point now. So I'm not getting this, I'm getting just one area. So this isn't gonna move on this end as much as that does as I do it. I'm gonna walk back across, because we were at about 10, now we're at almost zero. Tap it a little more. Move it back in Y. Click, there. Now, I'm move over here out of the way again. Oh, that doesn't help when you're moving the wrong thing. Don't freak out if that happens. Just go back and start again. Close. See, we're at zero on that end. And about two. I'm gonna go just a tad bit more than what I need because I probably move that end when I do it. Okay, so that's pretty close. I'm gonna snug it down now. Just don't get crazy. We don't need Godzilla on here bending our clamps. All right, so I'm gonna adjust this to zero. There's zero. And go the other way again. So you always wanna check it after you've tightened it because you might move it a little bit. You don't wanna assume anything. Check, check, check. Kind of like measure once, cut twice. Measure twice, cut once. Because if I don't check this and I cut the first part and it's screwed up, like I should have checked that again. So now I'm gonna put a lot more pressure on it. You can call it whatever you want. I'm still not gonna go so much pressure that I start bending the clamps. If I gotta tighten it down that much, I need a better work holding system. So now we can see it's at a little over zero. There's zero. Walk back across one more time and pretty good. But one more thing we want to cover before we finish up. So that's how you dial in a vise. Get it snug down, everything's good. Make sure it's when you walk up to a vise like this, you dial it in, it's good. Make sure it's good and tight. Because we had one just the other day, all dialed in good, started cutting it, it wasn't tight. The pressure of the tool moved it out. Here we got a part, and here I got a part shape. Not what we wanted. So I walked up and you could just about fall down because they were so loose. So always make sure they're tight. Last thing, if I move and I'm dialing and I happen to, oh shoot, I fell off the end of the vise. Don't just crank back onto it because theoretically, here's the back of my vise. My indicator was against it. I came off, now it dropped behind. Now it dropped behind it like that. If I go back over, I'm gonna clip that needle and possibly break it off. So I usually just reach behind it like this, walk it back over. So now I've pushed that needle away, coaxed it back on top and you're okay. Don't just go back the other way. If you got enough deflection, you can literally snap that needle off or bend it. I don't like to mistreat $100 worth of tooling quite like that. So one more time, we're gonna check it. Looks good. I'm gonna just double check a little bit of the up and down and make sure this vise doesn't have a chip under it this way. I'm gonna go Z and just carefully walk it down. Don't get crazy, you don't wanna smash anything. So we go down to zero, back up, walk it off. So I just dialed in the vise. we're good to go. Thanks.